There's a big population in Ballina, and that large North Mayo hinterland that the town serves, you know, we're here for all of them. I suppose at the moment Ballina is developing a tourist product, you know, and while we form part of that, our main commitment is to the people of Ballina. That's what we were built for, you know, and that's what we're here for, and we're keen to make that clear to all local arts groups. There are a lot in North Mayo, and Ballina Arts Centre aims to be the hub of creative activity like that. So ideologically, we would be more aligned to the arts. We are supported by the Arts Council of Ireland. Designing Ballina Arts Centre, we wanted to move away from the established model of auditorium and gallery. To that end, we developed, or we planned, a number of what I call artists' resource components in the building. And they are things like this, the dance studio. On the other side of this wall, there's a studio-sized drama rehearsal space. And then in the old building, we have things like a printmaking studio, an art workshop room, a music rehearsal room that we've developed with an organization called Music Generation Mayo. That space is fitted out with drum kit, electric guitars, keyboards. This is the auditorium. This is where we present all of the film, theatre, music and dance in our programme. It's got 230 seats. We wanted to have a sense of intimacy in the space. For an art centre in a town like Ballina, 230 seats is quite big. The stage is quite big. It's 15.5 metres wide and 7.5 metres deep. We wanted it big because we're keen to promote dance here in Ballina, especially ballet and contemporary dance. Of course, also that the big stage gives us the scope to put on large-ish productions in theatre as well. For acoustic theatre, the sound works really well, and of course that translates to music too. We have a large-ish film programme here throughout the year, with a number of small festival-type events and an ongoing film club programme. Theatre-wise, we aim to, I suppose, bridge the gap between local, non-professional, amateur drama stuff and touring professional theatre then. Ballina, like a lot of towns in Ireland, has a tradition of amateur drama, but wouldn't have a historic tradition of access to professional theatre on the doorstep.